welcome Carlos Arizate, the Hellenic Music Society of Northern California, whom you see seated in front of you, the Hellenic Traditional Arts Institute, proudly present the inaugural first program of the Greek Strings Ensemble. We've prepared a program of interest, both historical as well as cultural, and we ask you to join with us in this wonderful celebration.
Thank you very much, and good evening, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of all of us, I'd like to welcome you to the premier concert of Mizouki, Rebetiko, or Lay Music of Greece. I use three terms, which basically all mean the same. Take your pick, whichever one you like to use. First, I'd like to start by saying that Rebetiko, Mizouki, or Laiki music, Mushiki, as we say in Greece, is itself almost a cult or a religion. You either do or you don't. As in ancient Greece, if you remember the Pythagoreans, the Greeks clung somewhat greedily in their sharing of some of their cultures and knowledge. Feeling that, you know, they felt that it was exclusive and they wanted to bar outsiders. But we're going to depart from that philosophy and try to share with all of you a little of our musical heritage. In the interest of saving time, I'd like to refer to the music as Rebetiko or Rebetiko. Rebetiko developed in the towns and particularly in the ports of Greece when a large part of Greece was still occupied by the Turks. A large part of the Greek population lived in what is known as Asia Minor. There, Turkish music greatly influenced Greek music, although for obvious reasons, the Greeks vehemently will deny it, saying that the Turks borrowed music from the Greeks. But the fact of the matter is that a lot of the music today in Greece stems from the old Byzantine modal scale still used by the Turks and the Arabs. In 1922, the forced exodus of the Greek population from Asia Minor brought the refugees to Greece. Fleeing with only what they could carry with them, they arrived in Pyrrhus in the port city of Piraeus, where they settled in ghettos. The refugees brought the Turkish influence music with them, and eventually in the 20s and 30s, integrated into the Rebetiko music then prevalent in Greece. The Rebetiko music at that time in Greece developed in jails and hashish dens, believe it or not. The lyrics were very base, mentioning drugs, thievery, and sex. A little bit like today's teenage music. The musicians were in a class by themselves, shunning the general public, or better yet, I should say the general public shunned the musicians. They were generally considered low-class citizens. If you walked down the street with a bouzouki, people would avoid you like the plague. Perhaps rightfully so. If you wanted to hear bouzouki music, you would have to go to hashish den to hear it. You might say the musicians and composers of that era were the first hippies. At one time, King Paul of Greece even outlawed bouzouki and the bouzouki music in Greece. That's when the baglama became popular. As you see Joe as a baglama, the reason that became popular at that time is because the musicians could hide it under their top coat or their jacket and go to their hashish dens and play. During the period after World War II, the lyrics mellowed out and the music became integrated with the Western influenced music, not to be confused with country and Western. Dolly Parton and all that. Composers like Tsitsanis, Giotis Papiwanno, and Kaldaras, among others, brought the music out of the hashish dens and into the better nightclubs. In the 50s and 60s, Rebetiko music became quite fashionable with the upper class Greeks. Onassis, Narcos, Maria Callas, and all the Greek ship owners frequented all the clubs, and the prices, of course, became very, very steep. And if you go to Greece today, probably you can hardly afford to go to the Greek clubs because they are very expensive. But tonight you're going to hear it for only measly $10, so you got a bargain.
Thank you.
composer Mikis Thomaraikis, who wrote the music for motion pictures are for the Greek. Next song we'd like to do for you is by the great contemporary composer Vasilis Tsitsanis, Συνεφιασμένη Κυριακή, or in English, Cloudy Sunday.
Thank you.
Next song is,
we don't know who wrote it, major minor. It's Old Old Dolan's from the area of Haifari, which is across from the island of Vitirini. And it's way back, I guess, public domain. And it's written in the 9/8 rhythm. So for those of you who aren't familiar with Greek music, don't try to count it because you're going to go crazy.
Thank you.
to go to your old neighborhood. I'm going to come again this evening, drunk by the famous, very famous, Ioannis Papaioannou.
Thank you.
Next one is by a composer, Bayaderas Stokhatzikiriakio, translated into English, Stokhatzikiriakio. That's all you're getting out of it.
Thank you. Oh,
written up on Yasu. Don't ask me who wrote it, we don't know.
What does it mean?
I don't know that either.
Are you having a good time?
If you'd like to dance, you're welcome to do so. You can dance in the aisles, you can dance in the front, and you can dance on both sides behind the band.
Thank you. Before we continue with the show, why don't I take a few minutes to introduce everybody in the group, okay? And don't ask me last names. I'll give you their first. I'm the baby bazooki, the Bagalama, Joe. Way over to my left, on a 12-string guitar, Ted. Sitting next to him on a 6-string acoustic guitar, my friend from Mendocino, Bill. The best thing that happened to us, our lovely lady on the vocals, my cubana, Amalia. On the bass, in the back,
Pass Alex.
We don't want to say anything about Alex. Hidden behind his drums, a great drummer. And if you wanted to take a Greek, a guess at a Greek name, what would you guess?
George.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you.
this is one of those songs that goes way back that I was telling you about. University? Yeah, the university. And the university where they smoke the hookahs and the hashish. Bonito Arguile, which actually means the sound of the hookah, the Arguile. But it's about a guy telling somebody that he was convicted and sent to prison. And the only thing he had to look for in prison was, you name it, they had in those days in prisons.
Yeah.
κάτω στα λεμονάδικα, σαν παγνάνοντα την αγαπή Αμαλία.
Yeah.
took the original six-string bouzouki and decided that he couldn't play it fast enough, although he could, so he decided he wanted to play it faster, and turned it into what it's about today, into the four extreme. And in 1948, he wrote a song that was played in the movie Kameni Angeli, Lost Angels, not the one with James Cagney here, but another one in Greece, Assisia Dia. I'd like to perform that for you right now.
Thank you. right?
Oh, happy Mizuki translated into Greek. Karikimero Mizuki.
Percussion.
wonderful vocalist, Tom Molina. Bonnie Lightless, our wonderful guest artist from Sacramento. Of Northern California together for the first time and hopefully for many, many more performances. Pablo. Institute, who working with Paul created this first